I think it's time for some homework.
Time to do some homework.
Hello?
Yes?
Hi. Who do I have on the phone?
Shadrach O'Bang.
Well, hello. You got some work for us to do on the board?
Yes.
Excellent.
Okay, let me go to the board, and then you can read me your problem, okay? All right, first, can I ask you to turn your TV down so that I can hear you?
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Okay, now, could you tell me your problem?
The problem is use the number line to show and explain why 4/10 divided by 2 and 4/10 divided by times 1/2 both equal 2/10.
All right, so we have to show that these two things are equal. Now, what does your number line look like on your paper?
It goes from 0 to 1.
Okay, great. So I'm going to draw a number line, and I'm going to put 0 to 1. Are there any marks in the middle?
Yes.
How many?
10.
10, very good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Whoops, I was a little close. 8, 9, 10. All right, so I've got that. Is there anything else on there?
No.
No, okay. So you have a number line from 0 to 1 with 10 marks in between. So we've already got the number line split into tenths.
Yes.
So the first thing I would do is I would put a line segment to show how long 4/10 is, okay? So
Okay. Where
would you start?
We would start from the first mark.
Which is 0.
Yes.
All right, so I'm going to put my dot on 0. And how many little lines over am I going to go?
5.
You want 4/10, I thought.
Oh, 4.
4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to put a dot on that 4/10, okay?
Okay.
Now, if you connect it, that gives you a line segment that is exactly 4/10 in length.
Okay? Okay, yes.
So now, they said you want to divide it in two. Well, when you divide something in two, think about candy. If you were going to give candy out to your friends and divide it between you and one other friend, would you break it up evenly?
Yes.
Yes. So that's what we have to do here. So we're going to break this up into two equal parts. So if I have 4 lines, where is an equal piece?
An equal piece is 2.
At the 2. So I'm going to put a different color dot on 2/10. And I'm going to label that 2/10 and 2/10. So we just broke that into two parts, right? So we have part 1 and we have part 2. And that's what division means.
Yes.
Okay. So
Okay. Now,
pardon?
Yes.
Okay. So now we got to do the 4/10 times 1/2. That whole breaking it into two parts was easy, right?
Yes.
So now how do we, I'm going to do just another number line right below it.
Okay.
This way you can see the two pieces.
Uh-huh.
And 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, there we go. We got our 4/10. Again, I'm going to put it on there.
Okay.
4. There's my 4/10 again.
Yes.
Now I want to times that by 1/2, you said?
Yes.
Okay. So if I'm timesing that by 1/2, I literally have to look at changing that denominator a little bit. Okay?
Yes.
Because remember, when we multiply fractions, we multiply across?
Yes.
All right. So I have to put each one of these so that they are split in half. So I'm going to do another little line.
Uh-huh.
Now, if I were to go all the way over to 1, how many lines would be all the way over across?
4.
Now, if I were to go all the way over here to 1, and I have my 10 lines already,
uh-huh,
and I were to split each and every one of these in half again,
5.
How many of them would there be?
5.
What's 2 times 10?
20.
There'd be 20 segments, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to show that this, cutting them in half, so I want to cut this in half. Wait a minute, I'm confusing myself here. And I want half of what's there, what do I have?
Okay.
I have 4/20, right?
Yes.
But 4/20 is equal to what?
4/20 is equal to 2/10.
2/10. So you just did on a number line showing that cutting it, dividing it into two pieces, or also cutting everything into halves or multiplying by half, gives you the same exact number.
Yes.
Okay?
Okay.
Thank you for calling, and would you please give us a call again?
Okay.
Thank you. Bye-bye.